Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Kia mea tia tau e paiai, ki runga ki te whenua, ki arite anō ki tō te rangi. Good morning and welcome to morning prayer on Wednesday. I'm here in the organ loft of the Lady Chapel. We're called today to make full use of the present opportunity to give thanks every day for everything. So let's take a moment now to thank God for something which we're grateful for this day. We cannot serve God and money. We cannot be slave to two masters. So we shall enter by the narrow gate. The gate is wide that leads to perdition, and many go that way. But the gate to life is small, the road is narrow, and those who find it are few. If we want to be with Jesus, we must forget ourselves, carry our cross and follow. If we want to save our life, we will lose it. But if we lose our life for Christ and for the gospel, we will save it. With us, it is impossible, but not for God. Only God can save us. In everything we do, in our troubles, difficulties, and hardships, we show we are God's servants. By purity, patience, and kindness, by the Spirit, and by our love, we show ourselves for what we are. We may seem poor, but we make many rich. We seem to have nothing, but we possess all that there is to have. Let's pause now for our reading, which is taken from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 11, beginning at verse 27. Jesus' authority is questioned. Again, they came to Jerusalem. As he was walking in the temple, the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders came to him and said, "By what authority are you doing these things? Who gave you this authority to do them?" Jesus said to them, "I will ask you one question. Answer me, and I will tell you by what authority I do these things. Did the baptism of John come from heaven, or was it of human origin? Answer me." They argued with one another, "If we say from heaven, he will say, 'Why then did you not believe him?' But shall we say of human origin?" They were afraid of the crowd, for all who regarded John as truly a prophet. So they answered Jesus, "We do not know." And Jesus said to them, "Neither will I tell you by what authority I am doing these things." We come now to a time of intercession where we bring before God the needs of the church, the world, those who are sick, and those who mourn. We still ourselves in his presence. Lord Jesus, you are our exalted Lord, and you have been given all authority. We seek your intercession. Pray for us this day. Lord Jesus Christ, you are the great High Priest, living forever to intercede for us. Pray for your church, your broken body in the world. Pray for us, your people, as we seek to serve and minister and live amongst one another. Pray for our brothers and sisters who don't have freedom to worship, those who are persecuted. Bring them your comfort. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, you are the King of righteousness, enthroned at the right hand of the Majesty on high. Pray for the world and make it subject to your gentle rule. Pray for the brokenness of our ecology. Pray for the war-torn and weary. Pray giving thanks for great beauty in mountain, river, ocean, and animal. Pray for us as we seek to share the resources of the world with wisdom and equity. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, Son of Man, drawing humanity into the life of God, pray for your brothers and sisters in need, distress, or sorrow. Pray for the sick and those who tend them. Pray for the diseased, in mind, body, or spirit. Pray for the wounded, the refugee, those caught on borders, those suffering from natural disaster. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, you are pioneer of our salvation. You bring us to your glory through your death and resurrection. And so we pray you would receive this day into your presence those who have died, trusting in your promises. We name before you now those whom we commit to your tender care. Bring comfort and healing to all who mourn. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Jesus Christ, you are Lord over all. You are ascended far above the heavens and yet present intimately with us through your Spirit. Pray for us who long to receive the gifts that you give, for work in your service. We speak out to God those things that we wish Jesus to intercede specifically for us this day. Lord, hear us. Lord, graciously hear us. Lord Jesus, you are the first fruit of all creation. Keep the church in the unity of the Spirit and in the bond of peace until you bring the whole created order to worship at your feet, for you are alive and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We pray together the Lord's Prayer. E tō mātou mātua I te rangi, kia tapu tō ingoa, kia taimai tō rangatiratanga, kia meati atou e paiai, ki runga ki te whenua, kia rite anō ki tō te rangi. O mai kia mātou ai nei, he tarau mā mātou mō tēnei rā, murua o mātou hara, me mātou hoki e muru nei I o te hunga e hara ana kia mātou. O hoki mātou e kawea kia whakawaia, engari whakaorangia mātou I te kino. Nau hoki te rangatiratanga, te kaha me te karoria. Ake, ake, ake. Amine. Creator of the universe, infinite and glorious, you give us laws to save us from our folly. Give us eyes to see your plan unfolding, your purpose emerging as the world is made. Give us courage to follow the truth, courage to go wherever you lead. Then we shall know blessings beyond our dreams. Then will your will be done. Almighty and everlasting God, we thank you that you have brought us safely to the beginning of this new day. Keep us from falling into sin or running into danger, and guide us to do always what is right in your eyes. Holy and enabling Spirit, give wings to our morning prayers. May those we support and cherish with our love receive your grace to help them in their need. Amen. Thank you so much for joining me for morning prayer. I pray God's richest blessings on you for your day ahead.